You gotta crack a couple of eggs to make an omelet, right? You know that saying about how you, you get it, okay? Now get this. Drug smugglers have been smuggling their cocaine and fentanyl in omelets. That's right. If you go to Denny's in certain towns and you get the wrong order, you may want to bring a drug dog, just give it a sniff. Because the most important meal of the day may have you craving more, much more, if you get my drift. So in other words, listeners, make your own omelets at home and avoid this nightmare. Now, I got a full dock on these shores, the shores of the country slaughterhouse. My slaughterhouse, where it's windy out here. So grab the ropes. We gonna lose the sails. We're going down. Oh shit, we're gonna die. We'll talk about the DNC. We've got ourselves a special interview. And we're going to talk about some hot topics. And then we're going to talk about another acronym. And we'll be right back after a word from a sponsor.
Whoa, man, what are you doing? That's the solo. Keep going.
Coming this year to theaters, probably. Who could have done this? Who does this kind of thing? Who out there would have even done this? How could this have been done? Was this? Could this have been done?
There's some bad fish out there, John. Some bad fish.
Bad fish coming this summer. Howdy ho, howdy ho, howdy ho, alright. This is the very important interview section of the show that I mentioned. Okay, I got the next. Well, maybe the next vice pres of this here United States, J.D. Vance. J.D., what's happening, man?
Hello, Cowman. I've been a long-time listener since your DJ was in the 90s.
Whoa. So you're a fan? Like, a real fan?
Oh, yeah. My wife and I used to put you on to get into the mood.
What mood? Oh, wait. Ew. Why you gotta tell people this kind of stuff? And by people, I mean myself. Why did you just tell me that?
Well, now we're connected, right? Like men do. We're bonding.
No, okay? Men connect without looking or speaking to each other. Watching football or baseball, basketball, sometimes soccer, if your only goal is to turn it off. That's how we end up calling one another brother.
Well, my brother and I used to wrestle around on the sofa.
Oh, here we go again. Stop now while you're not yet in last, okay? Just like 8th or 9th in the polls, or if this was Mario Kart. Now, JD, people been calling the Rebs weird. Rebs as in rebels, Republicans. What do you have to say about that?
Well, the Libs want to call me weird or fat, stupid, and ugly. Then I'll wear it as a badge of honor. Like, you know what I think is stupid, fat, and ugly, Cowman? Fentanyl. Streaming across the border. Abortions on children. That's stupid, fat, and ugly.
Whoa. Way to put that into words, I guess.
And if not letting a child be castrated is stupid, fat, and ugly, then I am indeed stupid, fat, and ugly.
Right. Yeah, this is a great spot to end the interview.
I'm one of those spiders who doesn't really cause any problems. But you just spent 15 minutes trying to kill me with your divorce papers. And now that bitch gets Timmy and the house. If you had Allstate, none of this would happen. Allstate, are you in good hands?
This is Talking Business. And we're going to talk business. Jimmy, aka Jimothy, aka Mr. Beast, that's the name that half of the whole goddamn planet knows pretty well by now. From cleaning up the oceans, giving away sports cars, and even secretly overthrowing small governments, he's done it all. He even has his own chain of ghost restaurants that, like a symbiote, share a host body with half of the Red Robins out there. Take my advice. Just go with the Robin, okay? Well, it's been in a lot of hot water lately. Having just gone through the pedophile allegations aimed at his friend Ava Chris Tyson, it turns out that a lot of his employees are weirdos, according to a whistleblower. Apparently, one of them has the nickname Delaware, because he's not allowed back in that state due to his sexual deviance. This has been compounded with the fake video allegations, which, I mean, I'm not even fazed by that part. If you were to come to me time traveling from the future, out of breath, with bullet wounds in your shoulders and legs, you know, as though you have vital information and they're after you, and this is what you had to tell me? I say, not even a little surprised. Which, I imagine for someone like that to hear, it would be devastating in this hypothetical situation. But there's more, because it seems like Mr. Beast has been allegedly breaking gambling laws, having live streams where he would often adjust the chances of a winner midstream. You know, so many purchases and we will announce the winner, turns into so many more, and then we will announce the winner later. That kind of thing. You know what that reminds me of? Of when Olive Garden tried to tell me that the never-ending breadsticks only lasted until 5 minutes before closing. To which I had to humble them and show them that I had 5 minutes of breadsticks left in me.
Hello.
Hey there. To the airport?
Yes, thank you.
Just kick back in those seats that recline and ease your mind with the built-in headphones while you watch Zootopia.
Wow. This is pretty cool.
Yeah, and watch this. Oh, self-driving capabilities.
Whoa.
Yeah, I can eat the subway while my car drives itself.
That's pretty cool, but we are going pretty fast towards that wall.
Chill. Elon's got it.
Tesla.
We're finally back to this segment, the hot topics.
That's hot.
All right, so let's get into it. A lady from the USA.
USA, USA, USA.
No, stop, poop. Not this time, okay? Okay? Now isn't the time to be proud to be an American, all right? Because get this, she was banned from the Kruger National Park in South Africa for sexually assaulting an elephant. She got right up on his dong, you know, as whatever sick freak took a pic and posted it.
Ooh, I took back the USA thing I did earlier.
Yes, good. Alright, now she's facing charges from not just an elephant, but also a zebra and a hippopotamus. Moving on, in other news, Blackstone, which owns Ancestry.com, has become a $4.7 billion company. That ain't good. Now they own your DNA, dummies. I'd never send my saliva to them. I say, if you don't know where you're from, then it's probably for the best. Just let it go, all right? Move on. Or make it up. Because, say you do find out that you're a quarter Cherokee. Well now, you're the one who's got to tend to that small chunk of land that you get in the middle of Mojave. And chances are, it's not even going to be close to the casino. And now you got to weed whack and mow. No way. Leave the past in the past. Or else they'll clone you for the future. We'll be right back after a word. Wish.com still has cheap stuff, okay? Alright? You want gigantic headphones? We'll go out and find you some, okay? Hell, we'll invent them if we have to. Because not even we know how Timu sells them. For 99 cents. DNC. What does it mean? It means don't not cry. It's the DNC. We're going to hear from a longtime correspondent and other fan of the show, Incognito. He's been playing both sides of the government since I've been on air. Which must mean he's like the mailman or something. But I don't know. I don't know for sure. And I don't want to blow his cover. After all, he's my inside guy. Incognito, what you got for me? What was the scoop at the DNC, huh?
One sec. Just got it. Okay, sorry about that, Cam. I had to work my way past security. Thank you. You're a patriot. I gotta say, the scoop... Well, it was chocolate chip if we're talking ice cream. If we're talking politics. It was a lot of secrecy and backroom deals that nobody saw. I even asked around. Nobody saw the things that I'm about to tell you, Cowman.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa. We talking an exclusive here?
Oh, yes. If by exclusive you mean I haven't yet been paid by another news company to reveal my information there, then yes. This... isn't exclusive.
Well, don't leave me on my tippy toes. I'm gonna get tired real fast. What's going on?
First off, the cheese spread was suspiciously to die for. As though some mysterious donor knew that I lacked provolone and had a whole tray of just provolone. Questionable in its own right, but enough about cheese. I've got an insider knowledge that Tim Walz was good friends with the horse of which he supposedly drank a gallon of Fitz semen. They were war buddies who were awarded medals of honor at the same time. And that, should Tim Walz pass away as vice president, the transfer of power goes directly to the horse.
Nuh-uh. We are not letting horses run this country. I damn near died fighting against that future. And I'll do it again. Radio DJ wars of the 2020s. Kill the horse president. I'll do it.
Cowman, you are absolutely correct, as usual.
Hey, what about, you know, that lady that was in front of the Mona Lisa? You know, the one who was naked? You got any deets on her? You know, maybe some digits of hers?
Fortunately, Cowman, I know literally nothing at all. But you want to know what's equally interesting? Kamala Harris. Whenever she's laughing, as if she is an insane person.
Yeah?
She doesn't actually think whatever she said or was laughing at was really that funny. She's just overreacting. Not many people know that. Possibly nobody else in the world knows that.
Well, if you gave me the better part of 10 minutes, I could probably have guessed. Well, anyways, great reporting out there. I guess we'll hear from you the next time our country is in terrible danger.
That's right, Cowman. Stay safe out there. COVID-27 is supposed to affect your dongs, so get ready. Incognito out.
Wait! Whatever. That man will get a medal named after him one day, for sure. We'll be back after this message. Our final thoughts on this edition of The Country Slaughterhouse. I just wanted to touch on one last thing that may be revolutionary, or may have been, but in the least exciting way possible, yet still very serious. In this day and age, streamers have such a presence that they often have politicians appear to provide their side towards younger viewers in the desperate hope that they even vote. Bill Bob Bush tried this when he visited the Boys and Girls Clubs throughout Illinois and tried to get them to play bocce ball. And let's just say he realized that none of them were even close to voting age and elected instead to do the same at old folks' homes. Two extremes, both of which do not vote. But his heart, being in the right place, is unlike these political streams that have been happening. Donald Trump was recently on Aiden Ross, the Chair Sniffers stream, where they talked about how either one of them could be president, for all they know, about how to do the job, but then Aiden Ross gave the president a Rolex. Now, there's a little thing called the FEC, Federal Election Commission, and they know all about this stuff. They got their eyes on every little backroom deal. Every time you pass the ketchup to a political candidate, they're going to know. And if the value of a donation is over a certain amount, your ass is grass. Obviously, Aiden has no idea how any of this works, and he would have been possibly the youngest FEC violator should he had not taken the Rolex back. What a world we live in. Now, I'm not running for office, but you can FEC violate me anytime you want. And yes, I do accept Rolexes. This is your Cowman, signing off. Bust a move, Boise!
Oh man, what are you doing? That's the solo. Keep going.